Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala asraf al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqa wa arzuqna tiba'a. Wa arina al-batila batila wa arzuqna ajtinaba. Allimna ma yanfa'una wa anfa'na bima allamtana wa zidna ilma. Akhrijna min zulumat al-wahmi wa akrimna binur al-fahm. وأنم علينا يا عظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Continue where we stopped last week, the journey with Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه, the first Khalifa of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we said the meaning of Khalifa, Khilafa, is taking over. Whether taking over someone, or taking over the job of someone, or taking over whatever from someone. So Al-Khalifa, he, Abu Bakr, had taken the responsibility of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam as the leader of the Muslims. And continued that after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And we experienced the khilaf that happened between the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum in the beginning, and how there was a bit of misunderstanding between Abu Bakr and Fatima, and because of that misunderstanding between Abu Bakr and Fatima, it also went on to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and few family members of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now, alhamdulillah, the Muslim nation's word became one. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away, the Muslims around or surrounding the Medina and Mecca had turned upside down. There was a turnover 180 degrees where a lot of people start to leave Islam, which they call in Arabic ar-ridda. And the ridda is when someone becomes a Muslim or who's a Muslim and then he leaves Islam or upstates Islam. Khalas, he no longer believes in Islam. Whether he left all Islam or denying one of the aspects of Islam. Because in Iman and Islam, there's no such thing called 90% Muslim or 95% Muslim or 99% Muslim. It's either you believe 100% in all the beliefs of Islam or you're not a Muslim. So what happened is, a lot of the tribes and the cities that surround Medina and Mecca had left and upstated Islam. And the Ridda started to expand among the Arabs in the Arabian Peninsula. The only three tribes, the only three cities that did not leave Islam is number one city that were firm on their religion, the city of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Medina. The second city is the city of Ta'if. And the amazing thing is, as you've already know, that Ta'if are the last people that became Muslims. They were the one of the cities that did not leave Islam. And the third city that was on the edge of leaving Islam was the city of Mecca. The city of Mecca. They spoke about leaving Islam. Here Muhammad had passed away, then what's the point of worshipping Allah after Muhammad? What's the point of following Islam after Muhammad? So the people of Mecca, they were on the edge of leaving Islam. But there was few companions who stood a very firm and strong stance that made a lot of people be firm in their religion. The Amir that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala assigned for Mecca had fled from Mecca because he saw a lot of people turning against him. But one of the companions, his name is Labid. Labid was a poet. And he was captured in one of the wars of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam against the non-believers. And he was a man that used to talk bad about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and the companions. And he used to make up poetry. They used to abuse the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and the Muslim females. So when he was captured in one of the battles, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked the Prophet, "Oh Prophet Allah, let me kill him." So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said no. Then he said, "Oh Prophet Allah, let me break his teeth. I will never ever speak a poetry after this." So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him, "Oh Umar, what makes you know that these teeth, that mouth, could be used for a good stand one day?" So at this moment, the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam became true. Where Labid stood in front of all the people of Makkah, and a narration and orator drew his sword and he said, that whoever are he leaving Islam, or cause for leaving Islam, I'll chop his neck with my own sword. And people thought that Labid's got a lot of people behind him. So a lot of them backed off and a lot of them stuck to Islam. So subhanAllah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam before them. The people that left Islam, they were on a different levels. The majority of them left Islam as a total. We don't want to know anything about Islam. We don't want to know anything about Allah, about Muhammad. We don't want to know anything about Medina, about anything to do with Islam. That's a full riddah. And the other type of people, they believed in some of the principles of Islam and stayed performing those principles, but they don't want to practice some of it, especially when it deals with money, zakat. So there was a group of them, they prayed and they worship Allah and everything, but they don't want to pay zakat or believe in zakat, which is kufr. And the third type is, people among the tribe stood up and started to say they are prophets. And I mentioned that last week. There was over 5 to 6 different people from different tribes who claimed they are prophets. One of them is Tulayha ibn Khuwaylid. He stood up and he said he's a prophet. The other one is Musaylama. And the third one is Al-Aswad Al-Ansi from Yemen. And the fifth one is Laqit from Oman. The fourth one is Laqit from Oman. The fifth one is a woman. Her name is Sujah, who had the followers from Taghlib. And she was a female. Now Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu wanted to continue something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had left behind before he died. And that was the army and the trip of Usama bin Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was on his deathbed and the news went out that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam is facing death, the trip of Usama, where had the majority of the companions, and especially the big and great companions in that trip, backed off from going to the battle until they see what happens with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away, a disagreement happened between the companions in the presence of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu on what they should do to continue the journey of Osama bin Thabit, or to keep him here. Maybe a lot of the people of the non-Muslims are going to attack Medina, because the majority of Muslims turned away from Islam. The Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, we became like a white hare in a black cow or buffalo. We became like a white hare in a black buffalo. And it is like we're very small and minor compared to the big number that people turned away from Islam. And now what makes it now? These people maybe want to attack Medina. I want to invade Medina and take over what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left behind. So that we're on a dangerous position. So Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu had his opinion that we should not send Usama and his troop, because if we're going to send Usama radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Usama bin Haritha, I made a few times. It's Usama bin Haritha radiallahu ta'ala anhu. If we're going to send the troop of Usama bin Haritha radiallahu ta'ala anhu and behind him a lot of the companions, then the Medina will be left alone with no army to protect the Medina. And Umar ibn Khattab said, let's pause the troop of Usama and let them protect the Medina. What makes you know what happens? And some of the companions said that no, we sent the troop of Usama and continue the journey of Usama. And others said no, they took the opinion of Umar ibn Khattab and said no, we'll leave Usama here. So Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the man that were here, he's a humble man, very small, very, very skinny and weak, had a strong stance in that position. Where radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, wallahi, I would not stop something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted in his life. Wallahi, if I was left alone in Medina and to fight all those non-Muslims, I'd fight them on my own. Even if I was left alone to fight him. And then he grabbed Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu and shook him and told him, أَجَبَّارٌ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ خَوَّارٌ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ. Oh Umar, you're a brave man in the jahiliyyah. You're a brave man in the ignorant days. And you're a coward in Islam. You fear people in Islam. At the time of jahiliyyah, at the time of the corruption, you never used to fear anyone or you do anything. And now in Islam, you're a coward and you fear...